Hi Grace, Mrs. Cooper here. I'm going to teach you a little bit about your new math packet that you have this week. You're going to be doing a geometry packet. I have the same paper right in front of me that you're going to be working from as I teach you through this. So we're going to be learning about geometry, which is the study of lines and shapes and measurement. And I'm going to go through this page with you so you have it in front of you while I'm teaching it through with you, okay? It says parallel and intersecting lines. We're going to learn about two different kinds of lines and what they do today. The first kind of line is called a parallel line. Parallel lines are lines that go side by side in any direction. They're the same distance apart, but they never meet and they never cross. If you look around your house, you probably see a lot of parallel lines all around you. If you looked at your window, you would see pairs of parallel lines in your window. I'm going to try and draw some curtains hanging beside my window here, and some curtains over here. And maybe there's a windowsill right here, right? You can look outside your window. This line and this line are parallel to each other. They are the same distance apart and they stay that same distance apart, even if we drew them out. This line right here, Grace, and this line are parallel lines. They are the same distance apart and they stay the same distance apart, okay? So those are called parallel lines. The other kind of line we're going to talk about are called intersecting lines. Those are lines that cross each other, and they can cross each other in any old direction. They can cross each other going sideways like the letter X. They can cross each other going up and down like your window panes in your window, or across, or the letter T. Those are lines that cross each other. They are called intersecting lines. Now, when we talk about the word line, there are two different kinds of lines that I want you to know. One is called a line segment. And a line segment has two endpoints. The other kind of line is called a ray, okay, or a regular line. And it has one endpoint here, and it keeps going in one direction, okay? Other kinds of lines, or just plain old lines, have no endpoints, and they just continue on in both directions forever. So we use arrows to show those. So if you look at the top of your paper today, Grace, it says, complete each sentence, draw the figures. The first one says, a line segment has blank endpoints. So we're going to, I'm going to grab my eraser here. We are going to answer that question for you here, and I want you to do it along with Mrs. Cooper, okay? A line segment has two endpoints. We're going to put the number two in that box. And then it says draw a line segment. So I'm going to draw a straight line, and I'm going to put little dots on either end of it, and that's a line segment. Number two says a line has blank endpoints. Well, a regular line has zero endpoints. And it has arrows on both sides of the line to show that it keeps going in both directions. So draw your line like that. Now the next part is a matching part. It says write the letter of the lines, line segment, parallel lines, and intersecting lines. And on your paper, you have some choices right here. So you're gonna look for number three, lines. If you look carefully at your paper, you can see that E is showing lines, C is showing a line, B is showing lines, and you can write all of those down because all of those have arrows beside them, okay? Number four says line segment. Well, the only one that has endpoints is letter A. So number four is letter A. Number five says parallel lines. Now these are lines that go right beside each other, but never get closer together and never cross each other. Can you see what letter is showing lines like that? Letter E, that's right. Letter E is showing parallel lines. And then number six says intersecting lines. Well, I see two letters that show lines that are crossing each other. Can you see the two letters that are showing lines that cross each other? Letter F and letter D are showing lines that cross each other right here and right here. So you can write those letters on the line in the box, okay? Now, number 7 says use the map. On your paper, there's a little map here showing streets in a neighborhood, okay? And it wants you to write down the names of the streets that are parallel to each other. So let's look at the Washington Avenue at the top and then Jefferson Avenue. Washington Avenue goes like this and Jefferson Avenue goes like this. Those two lines are parallel to each other. So for number 7, I would write Washington and Jefferson Avenues, okay? And then it says there's another pair. Oh, if I look this way going up and down, this street is parallel to this street. So I'm gonna write down Vermont Street and, can you read the next one? Illinois Street. Those two streets are parallel to each other. So I would write that for my second answer right here. And then number 8 says, name the streets that intersect each other. Well, if you look closely, Grace, we can see one street crosses another street, crosses another street, crosses another street. There are 4 different intersections on my paper. So I can write that Vermont crosses Washington. I can write that Vermont crosses Jefferson. I can write that Illinois crosses Washington. And Illinois crosses Jefferson. So those are my answers for the bottom of the page. Have fun working on this one, Grace. Make sure you keep your packet stapled together. Don't take any pages off of this. And we'll have some more fun talking about geometry later on tomorrow. Have a good day, honey. Love you. Bye-bye.